for that. After Charlotte with a rundown of what else is happening, let's get up to date.
Eamon, thanks very much. Good morning. Surgeons at one of Britain's top children's hospitals have opened a groundbreaking new operating theatre. Computers at Alderhay Hospital in Liverpool can now build a 3D map.
What can I say?
So there you are. Has that lulled you into a deep sense of relaxation now?
No, I'd rather have the gold machine in wherever it was, Abu Dhabi.
It'd be quite handy,
yes,
that, wouldn't it?
It was. When I was a youngster at Christmas, used to get gold coins, chocolate gold coins, we should point out, in a little bag.
And now you can get the real thing.
Pirate's loot type thing. Yeah, they can get the real thing. Thank you. Front pages of the papers. Let's see what the real thing is there. What else is happening news-wise? Charlotte with that.
Thanks, Eamon. Surgeons at one of Britain's top children's hospitals have opened a groundbreaking new operating theatre. Computers at Alderhay Hospital in Liverpool can now build a 3D map of the brain.
Well, I'm afraid the holiday's over because here comes James Whale with the newspapers. Well, your ears are about to be harangued.
I was just thinking that you and I should get onto the National Trust.
Well, with your archery, I thought you were going to say you could do a compilation of the thwack of a bow.
We could go shooting with bows and arrows. We could read. So we've got to do something like
and
that.
Record things.
Yeah, record things. Oh, come on, Eamon.
Maybe
cheer up
well,
a bit.
No.
It's
maybe
my
you
birthday.
Going through
I'm
the newspapers
older.
Now might just soothe all everybody okay. back to sleep this
right.
morning. If you've just woken up, you might just fall asleep again.
You there won't. We go. Okay, let's
no
start
chance.
Off.
Here we go.
Let's start off with the new twosome.
No,
I'm being very... No, yeah. Actually, to be honest, I'm quite hopeful of this.
The paper's saying here that perhaps we're looking at a new type of politics now, free from spin, and there can be no going back to the sort of Mandelson, Campbell sort of figures. I mean, do you really believe that?
No. I mean, I think the Clegg Cameron combo.
Do you know Charlotte's husband is a doppelganger for Nick Clegg?
Really?
Yes, it's true.
Is that right?
Well,
I never really
saw the resemblance until all this sort of, the recent leaders'
Just
debate
think,
started. And
you could have been in number 10.
There you go.
You could have been living.
Who's
Are they
it?
Living together, by the way, in number 10?
Well, the thing is, we haven't seen any removal vans yet, have we, to move out the brown stuff?
I did read, talking about newspapers, I read a story yesterday in the London Evening Standard that the residents in the road where Cameron and Clegg live, not very happy.
What? Well, not very happy?
Not very happy.
I mean, they're glad that they'll move out.
Well, they'd like them to move out earlier, apparently, according to a couple of residents, because there's so much security.
Yes.
They have to have passes to get into their own street.
Do you know, I think that would be nice, though. You wouldn't have to worry about any burglaries, would you?
Yeah, but you like
that sort of thing. Because
you
can't park your car.
You can't park your car,
they've got all these yellow bollards
everywhere. Okay.
Right, now this is a story in the Daily Star, and this is a girl who has been disciplined because she refused to dress as a Muslim.
If you go into a church here, you're supposed to wear a hat if you're a woman, aren't you?
Well, it used to be, certainly in the Catholic Church, you used to, as a woman, have to cover your head, but that rule doesn't really apply anymore. Charlotte is a canon's daughter.
Are you?
Yes. You don't have to wear a hat
Are you
in church.
Sure?
She's
a canon's daughter.
She is.
My God.
I think they're just happy if people turn up. I don't think there's a hats-only policy.
I think they probably are. So I think that the Owens family should be ashamed of themselves for stirring this up and trying to be too cute and clever. Now, there's another school story here.
Health and safety this time.
Yeah. I, one of the things that annoys me, I spent my life, my childhood, climbing trees, making camps, shooting bows and arrows.
That's the way you're spending these years, not your childhood.
Well, yeah, I've reverted back in my later years. Yeah. Well, you enjoy yourself, you know, a little bit of that.
He wants things to return to a common sense approach where schools have
discretion. I am with Graham.
And parents have discretion.
You know, you can't protect your children
all
the
time. Well, for instance, my son this week, who's 8 years of age, rugby at school, it's a prerequisite that they wear mouth guards, and that applies for health and safety.
You've not written and complained about having
no,
to
No, I
wear
think that's a good idea. I think that's fine.
No fight, yeah.
Yeah, I'm in favour of that sort of thing.
What are you worried about?
I'm not worried about
anything.
That's it. I'm saying not all of it is nonsense.
And
No.
Isn't the thing that some parents perhaps, you know, will go down the route of taking legal action, and that's why they've had to be really careful about how they do things.
Yeah, we've got to stop this kind of culture of suing every time you trip over something, which I think is ridiculous.
Yes, but then only the politicians can do something about that.
There we are, Mr. Clegg and Mr. Cameron, get on the case. Did I say Clegg before Cameron? What a slip up, I'm so sorry.
Yeah. It's interesting watching the body language as they went through number 10 yesterday, because it was the whole, you know, I'll pat you on the back. No, I'll pat you on the back. It's almost who can have the last pat on the back.
And do you think, I mean...
Slightly awkward, Charlotte?
Well, I don't know. I don't know whether that was a sort of stage managed thing or not, but I... I thought they seemed quite natural together, considering, you know, they've only literally recently come to
I think the other thing I would say is, in the past, and people are, you know, commentators are so critical of who represents this country, and the thought of Michael Foot, for instance, being Prime Minister wearing a donkey jacket in his hair, the way
that's
it was,
not on.
Or when John Prescott was Deputy Prime Minister in charge of the country at Question Time, whatever, when Tony Blair was out of the country, for a lot of image makers, that wasn't good enough. But here you have two young, impeccable, well-dressed looking men.
I have no problem with this, and I think they still look as if they want to just kiss each other on the cheek before they go in. And I'm impressed with the chemistry between them. Now, you know, because how difficult it is when you've got someone like Charlotte or Jackie, or you know how difficult building that chemistry is. Mm. They seem to have been able to... What are you laughing at? They seem to have been able to develop that very quickly.
Yes, even because, though they were openly hostile.
Yeah, but the interesting thing is, you know, people were talking about... We were talking about that on the radio yesterday. But afterwards, after the fight's finished, you put your arm around each other and say, well done, mate. How excited we were about Tony Blair.
Okay,
let's hope they do it.
That's your thought for the day from the birthday boy. What are you doing for your birthday?
Working.
Right.
On the radio, 4 o'clock this afternoon.
I'm feeling sorry for you.
Are you really?
Obliged to maybe do something for you.
This evening I'm free.
Okay.
Busy at lunchtime, but
we could have
a
competition this morning. Guess how old James is.
I'm 48. Listen, that's it. 48. Do you think I look okay for 48?
Well, look,
you
listen.
Very good.
There are no wrinkles on a balloon. It's very hard to tell. Thank you very much indeed, Mr. James Will there. Top stories here on Sky News Sunrise. James back in an hour's time with more within. In between all the politics this morning, let us know what sounds you would like to record for your own special album, however ridiculous, just for fun. At Sky Charlotte, news at sky.com. At Eamon Holmes, and this is at Sky Jackie with the sports headlines.
You tell me as well, creaking stairs, no way.
Last word to you, Charlotte, this hour.
Well, health and safety came up in the paper review, and Peter in Whitley Bay says our window cleaner isn't allowed to use ladders because of health and safety. So let us know if you've got any other stories like that to tell us.
Dirty windows upstairs. keep them coming. It's the first day of the new coalition cabinet. We've got the reports after this. Don't go away. Meeting it starts at 9 o'clock this morning, and we'll have full coverage of what emerges here on Sky News throughout the day. Results coming in from the city. Sainsbury's to report. Charlotte with the details.
Thanks, Eamon. Yeah, we've just had the breaking news from Sainsbury's. They're reporting that their pre-tax profits in the year up to the 20th of March were £610 million. That's the breaking news from the city in the last few moments that Sainsbury's have announced their pre-tax profits.
I wouldn't mind finding out. Very nice. Very, very nice. Let's have a look now through the morning newspapers, dominated by David Cameron and Nick Clegg's James Whale. No, that's something to do with the web. Yeah, you know that. Skynews.com. It's all there. Everything
looked
you ever
very similar
to
me, didn't it?
Eight.
Very, very similar.
That's a matter of debate. A few debates from James with what's in the papers after Charlotte with a rundown of what else is happening.
Thanks, Eamon. And Sainsbury's have reported pre-tax profits of £610 million. The figure relates to the year ending March the 20th. The result was better than expected.